Dylan. I was reading one of the Kingston newspapers online, and I saw your story. And I thought, I have to speak with you for my Vocal Vibes program, because what you did was very cool. And for someone your age to withstand the criticism you took, you probably took a lot of flack from schoolmates and stuff, that you stood your ground and actually finished what you wanted to do. I thought, yeah, we gotta talk. So thanks for taking the time to talk to me.
My brother's friend had leukemia, and I thought, oh, okay, I can donate my hair to him. But then we kind of realized that it takes 10 heads of hair and about $800 to $1,000 to make one wig.
That's a lot of hair, eh?
Yeah.
So you grew your hair for 2 years.
Yeah.
Was it making you nuts that your hair was so long?
Yeah, it was kind of like when I'm eating, I got a toque on. Whenever I'm doing anything, it was, I got a hat or something on my head to keep my hair in my face.
Yeah, so now you know what we girls go through, eh?
Yeah.
And I bet you weren't using a lot of product in your hair or anything, like to make it look, you know how guys do that? They put stuff in their hair to make it do whatever.
Yeah, I just sort of left it, brushed it, and then it was sort of the end of what I would do with it.
In the article that I read in the newspaper, it mentioned about your schoolmates teasing you and stuff. How did that feel?
It made me pretty sad because I knew I was doing it for a good cause and stuff like that, and they just weren't getting like what I was doing it for. And yeah. Then they'd make these ridicule jokes and all that kind of stuff that wasn't the nicest. So
yeah. And, you know, with all this stuff about bullying and don't bully, is it surprising for you that kids were actually doing that, given the amount of attention that's being put on don't do it?
Kind of, yeah, because of, like, we'll have assemblies and stuff like that where they talk about anti-bullying and all that kind of stuff, and then you see these kids come out and just...
They leave the assembly and start bullying people.
Yeah.
That really sucks. So when they found out, when you went back to school with your short hair, what has their reaction been?
A few people have said sorry and stuff like that, just, yeah.
Really? Some of them have actually said sorry?
Yeah.
That's commendable. What about the ones that haven't said anything? They're, you know, the really tough guys who are, like, too proud to say they're sorry.
They just kind of don't really talk to me anymore or that sort of stuff.
So yeah. But who needs that anyways, eh?
Yeah.
It was your older brother. One of his friends was diagnosed with leukemia.
Yeah.
And are you close to your older brother or his friend at all?
I'm close with my older brother, but I don't really know his friend a whole lot. He just kind of came home one day and said, Mom, my friend has leukemia sort of deal. And it was just...
You're 12. And for someone your age to not even be close to the person who is experiencing this serious health problem, for someone your age to say, hey, I want to do something about this, is really wild, because that's not out there. And like when the shows that you watch, the TV shows and music that is on pop radio, it doesn't talk much about, you know, doing good stuff.
Yeah.
Do you know why maybe you felt like doing something? Can you put it into words at all? Or
a boy on my hockey team had done it, and I thought, you know what, I can do that sort of deal.
The hair that you grew and was cut, how long was it? It's got to be at least 10 inches, right?
Yeah, it was 10 and a half in some places.
Okay, and so that went to...
Angel's Hair for Kids.
Angel's Hair for Kids, and they make wigs for kids with cancer and leukemia. Would you do this again?
Yeah.
Yeah? Because all the kids at school already know the deal, and
yeah.
Maybe you can challenge a few of them, especially the mouthy ones. It's like, how long can you grow your hair?
Yeah.
Right on. So do you have a timeline for when you might look at doing it again? Or?
I'm going to get it cut a few times, so maybe kind of beat the heat of summer and then get back into it.
What would you say to other kids that see stuff like that happen?
You know, if someone's making fun of you, just sort of walk away. Or
what did you do to stick to your guns?
I just kind of thought about it, and I thought, I've come all this way, why stop now sort of deal.
So other than growing your hair for really good causes, what other stuff are you into?
A lot of sports like hockey, BMX, soccer, swimming, all that kind of stuff.
Right on. Well, I've really enjoyed talking with you. Thank you very much.